and welcome to the Virtual Nature School. I'm Claire Warden and I'm delighted that you're with us on our fourth session. What we've been looking at is the wonderment of ice, how it traps things, how water that's a liquid, when it gets really cold, transforms into something called ice, a solid thing. So it can trap items in it. And today what we're going to do is not look at objects being trapped, but how we can look at colour and ice. Let's have a look at the film and see what it makes us think about.
Welcome to session four of our inquiry, all about ice. What we're going to be doing is thinking a lot more about the colour of our ice. So we've tried looking at different shapes, we've explored trapping things inside our ice, and now we're going to move forward to looking at all the different things we can use to change its colour. Normally, when we think about colouring ice, it's because we're going to eat it. So we can just crush up our ice in a machine and then we can put some beautiful juice on top and it looks and tastes delicious. So what we're going to do is think about some of those flavours, the orange or satsuma and the lemon, and think about whether or not they would add a colour. Because often when we add these flavours, we don't actually turn the lollipop bright orange or bright yellow. What tends to happen is that we add a fruit juice to it or a vegetable juice to it. Here are some that are different colours. So we can see that they've got fruit inside them as well as having a juice. So that watery juice is the thing that's gone really hard. And so as you get to eat these lollipops, you have a little bit of the juice and you have the fruit or the vegetable to chew. When you have a lollipop mold, they look a little bit like this. So you have something you can stand up in your freezer. You put a stick in normally because it just makes it easier for you to hold. Sometimes when we're at nature school, we make our own sticks to go into our lollipops because by using the branches around us, we can actually just use those rather than buying lollipop sticks. Here are some that are full of mixed fruits. They've got blueberries and raspberries and strawberries. And when you put all those together in a machine called a liquidizer, it ends up giving you this beautiful red color. You don't have to have a lollipop mold, of course. You could just use your ice cube tray. And then that means you pop one of these in your mouth and it just melts slowly. Now, there are all sorts of things that give color. Sometimes we use fruit, but sometimes you can use a vegetable. So beetroot is something that we tend to think of as vegetables, but they give you a wonderful red colour. So we can use the colouring from beetroot to make everything from marshmallows to ice creams. Here's one that's a beautiful orange colour. I wonder if you can see what it might be made out of. There is a clue in this photograph. Here we go. It was made of carrot, orange, and something called turmeric, which is a spice. Gives it a lovely orange colour. So you wouldn't necessarily cut up a carrot and put it in there, but what we do is that we put them into a juicer, and that means we squeeze out all of the liquid, and then we put those things together in our ice lolly mould. Things that you might find useful to colour your ice. If you want to go to the shops, you might be able to buy some vegetable juices or some fruit juices that are already done for you. If not, you might decide to get your fresh fruit and explore how you can get the juice out of that, or you might decide to make a big smoothie, just blending together some lovely, delicious fruit. If you don't want to eat your ice cubes or your lollies, but you want to explore how colours work, it's quite a good game when you get food colouring and you make your ice cubes in red, yellow and blue. And that way you can experiment which two colours make a new colour. Some of us like to use milk in our ice cream making and we don't like just to use the ice and the water. There are all sorts of different animals that share their milk with us. One of them is the cow. This is a Jersey cow. And the milk is made for the baby calf. But over time, the cows continue to give us milk that we're lucky enough to be able to have to drink. We can also get milk from goats. Some of us prefer to have plant milk, and that means that we use the beans and we make them into a new liquid. So you might like soya milk. You might be somebody who enjoys coconut milk, or you might be somebody who drinks almond milk. So all of these come from plants. They don't come from animals like cows and goats and sheep. When we start to add milk or cream into our ice cream, it changes from being see-through to being opaque. These are some of the flavors that you might know of: strawberry, cherry, blueberry. So all of these give us a different texture, a different kind of ice cream. So one of the things we're looking at is how you can change the color of your ice. Whether it's just for playing with or whether it's for eating, I look forward to seeing and hearing about all of your experiments.
Wasn't that amazing? I am a massive fan of ice cream, and I'm sure everybody out there has a different flavor or color that they might like. I really enjoy the blues and those purples and the greens. So I'm going to explore today the idea of how I can make many different shades of green. I wonder what it made you think about. I wonder if you're sitting there right now wondering what experiment you could do to make new colors, to think about what things you could put in ice that perhaps you could eat, like orange juice or strawberry juice. Whatever it is that you decide to do, I look forward to hearing about your theories and ideas.